Diagnosing mental illness is very different to diagnosing physical illness. By and large, mental illnesses are still diagnosed through the assessment of signs and symptoms. With physical illnesses, on the other hand, after a presentation of signs and symptoms, we can usually confirm a diagnosis with actual physical tests, such as blood tests, scans, biopsies, etc. For centuries, we've been working on attempting to classify mental illnesses in order to understand them better and so be able to develop more effective treatments. It's been a long and difficult process. This process has produced two classification systems that are a bit like Bibles that mental health practitioners use to diagnose mental illness. The first one is called the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, and the most current edition is the DSM-5, which was published in 2013. This is the one I'm going to be referring to today. The second classification system is the International Classification of Diseases, or the ICD, and this is widely used in the UK and Europe. So why am I telling you this? Well, so that you understand that the way in which mental illnesses are thought about in terms of the category in which they belong and their diagnostic criteria may change from one edition to the next, whether we are talking about the DSM or the ICD. We're going to be talking about two categories of disorders that often occur comorbidly or concurrently, the depressive disorders and the anxiety disorders. First, we'll talk about the depressive disorders. Incidentally, coming back to what I was talking about before in terms of the changes we see from one edition of the DSM to another, we've begun to understand that bipolar disorders represent a bridge between depressive and psychotic disorders in terms of symptomatology, family history, and genetics. As a result, in the DSM-5, depressive disorders are no longer grouped with bipolar disorders as they were in the past.